Hi, I'm Vidini Ranasinghe. I'm from Sri Lanka and I am a G30 master's student in the chemistry program. So in my lab, we work on catalysis. Catalysts are substances that speed up a chemical reaction without getting used up themselves. So in that way, we can make many chemicals and substances that otherwise could not be made. In my research, we focus on photocatalysis. The photo bit implies that the catalyst is activated by light, for instance, sunlight. And that's why photocatalysis is a really important area of research. We can make chemicals in a renewable and sustainable way using only light as our energy source. An important photocatalyst that you might have heard of is titania. Titania is often used as white pigment in paint, paper, sunscreen, medicine, and even toothpaste. In fact, if you happen to shine UV light on it, it can actually start chemical reactions. You probably may have seen white walls chipping, flaking, with bits coming off. That's probably the titania paint reacting to sunlight. In my research, I'm trying to use titania to build new molecules. Previously, our group achieved elusive and uncommon carbon-carbon coupling using titania and light in water. This is a very influential, very green process. But the problem is that most organic molecules are not soluble in water. So in my work, I'm trying to change this method so that our system can accommodate these water-insoluble organic molecules as well. In that way, we'll be making our system more impactful and useful for broader synthetic applications. If I had to pick one experience, it would probably be the first time I visited Nara. Nara is an ancient city. It's actually where Japan's first empire was. And it's a very picturesque place with lots of dramatic history and ancient culture. It is also home to several UNESCO World Heritage Sites, one of them being Todaiji, which is a Buddhist temple. It's actually one of the largest wooden structures in the world, so visiting it in person was quite impressive. The grounds of the Todaiji actually extend into Nara Park, which is home to hundreds of sika deer. Sika deer are a symbol of Nara, and they are seen as messengers from the gods. I really enjoyed interacting with these deer, and I think I was most surprised by how at ease they were in the presence of humans. You can actually feed them these special treats that are for sale around the park, and some get quite playful and clever when they realize that you have these treats. They quickly try to befriend you and have even learned how to bow Japanese style to get into your good graces. Yeah, so I think Nara was a very unique and memorable experience with impressive visits to ancient temples and fun encounters with friendly wild deer.